particular degree meeting. It's the 350th anniversary of the birth of the degree meeting. Next year, he's by far the greatest composer of the French Baroque period, and he's probably the most unknown. There are reasons for that. He was on the list of Reims Cathedral. He died at the early age of 31. He published his premier livre d'or in 1699, but there never was a second one. So this is all we have of him. His musical stature is considerable, whereas François Couperin writes fugues in four parts, degree he writes in five parts. And the scope of his musical imagination in both length and in expressive detail is without parallel. He was admired by a no less figure than Johann Sebastian Bach, who copied out his entire livre around about 1709 to 1712. J.G. Dalton copied most of it, and they obviously learnt a huge amount from the Greek. Paradoxically, all we have is the first edition of 1699, and because his engraver was in Paris and he was in Reims, a few days coach travel, we think that the proofs were never corrected. And there are wrong titles in the edition, wrong notes, wrong accidentals, slurs misplaced, ornaments misplaced, wrong notes not erased, and therefore editing the degree is really a matter of faith more than scholarship. I've done my best after living with the music for many decades now. But the stature of the music is phenomenal. We're going to perform the Gloria in Excelsis, which is nine organ pieces separated out by the playing chant, sung by the choir and also sung in the gallery. So they start with Gloria in Excelsis Deo. I play the Et in Terra parts, where you hear the playing chant in the middle. And so we go the right way through Gloria in Excelsis until the organ finishes with the dialogue. Possibly, this might be the first time it's ever been performed in this church, for obvious reasons, it's a rather special event, and I hope you enjoy it. And we'll run the sequence through continuously, and then we'll have a chance to questions afterwards.